Here at the refugee camp, there are so many children, and they sit listlessly for much of the day. It's hard to see, but, you know, children are children, no matter the circumstances. And when we arrived, excitement was everywhere. I mean, they followed us around, they danced, they played. And there was one child in particular that really touched me, an absolutely beautiful little girl. Her name was Miriam, and she's 10 years old. And I mentioned her eyelashes. I mean, look at them. They're the longest you've ever seen. And I told her, learned in her local language, the word to say you're beautiful is tehusket. And so I said she was tehusket and was pointing at her eyelashes, you can see. Anyway, it turns out that no one had ever told her she was tehusket before, which was sort of a poignant moment for me. I mean, the children here really do make you smile, but it also makes you tear up, too, when you think about what their futures might be. There was one thing, though, that was disturbing that we wanted to share with you, and that was that the children often collect small birds and break their wings. They play with the birds sort of like a cat and mouse and fling them around to each other as the bird gets weaker and weaker. And a little boy told me that he does it because he has nothing else to do. And a local who came with us told them to stop torturing the birds. And they said, well, we're only going to stop if you give us soccer balls. And it's sort of a hard thing to even talk about because it's an awful image that they did. But it made us think, you know, we're going to give them soccer balls. But that's really a temporary solution. And we hope that more people will pay attention to the crisis that we've all seen tonight.